Hello students, today I am going to explain introduction to payment, module 3, lecture number 1. Payment is the durable surface material laid down on an area intended to sustain vehicular load or foot traffic such as a road or walkway. There are two types of payment, one is flexible payment, second one rigid payment. Flexible payment are also called bituminous payment or blacktop payment. Coming to the rigid payment or cement concrete payment or white surface payment. Here we can see the difference between a flexible payment and rigid payment. Under flexible payment, we have with the different layers, start from natural formation levels and sub-base, base course, surface course, surface dressing. And coming to the rigid payment, we have with only three layers, natural formation, base course and concrete slab. Then comparison between flexible payment and rigid payment. First one, design principle. Under flexible, empirical methods based on load distribution characteristic of the components. And rigid, designed and analyzed by using the elastic theory. Coming to the second one, materials. Under flexible payment, here we have with granular materials and rigid, made up of cement, concrete, either plain, reinforced or pre-stressed concrete. Flexural strength, under rigid, flexible payment, low or negligible flexural strength. Under rigid, associated with the rigidity or flexural strength or slab action, so the load is distributed over a wide area of subgrade soil. Fourth on normal loading, under flexible, elastic deformation, under rigid, acts as beam or cantilever. Fifth on excessive loading, under flexible, local deformation, under rigid, causes cracks. Stresses, under flexible, transmit vertical and compressive stresses to the lower layers, under rigid, tensile stress and temperature increases. Next one is design practice. Under flexible, constructed in number of layers. Under rigid, laid in slabs with the steel reinforcement. Next one, temperature. Under flexible, no stress is produced. Under rigid, stress is produced. Force of friction. Less deformation in the subgrade is not transferred to the upper layers. Under rigid, friction force is high. Opening to traffic. Under flexible, road can be used traffic within 24 hours. Under rigid, road cannot be used until 14 days of curing. Surfacing. Rolling of the surfacing is needed. Under rigid, rolling of the surfacing is not needed. Here we have with the picture of rigid payment and flexible payment. Here we can see the overall flexible payment is look like a RC slab, having transverse and vertical joints along with the toe and dowel bars. Toe and dowel bars is connected to the lateral and longitudinal directions. And coming to the flexible, there is no vertical joints. Here we can with the continuous surface and it gives a smooth surface to the movement of the vehicles. And here with flexible payment and rigid payment, by seeing the color we can identify whether which one is flexible and rigid payment. And black flexible payment having black surface and is poor visibility during night time, and rigid payment having good visibility during night time also. Requirements of payment. First one, sufficient thickness to distribute the wheel load stresses to a safe value on the subgrade soil. Second one, structurally strong to withstand all types of stresses imposed on it. Third one, adequate coefficient of friction to prevent skidding of vehicles. Fourth one, smooth surface to provide comfort to the road users even at high speed. Fifth one, produce least noise from moving vehicles. Sixth one, dust proof surface so that traffic safety is not impaired by reducing visibility. Seventh one, impervious surface so that subgrade soil is well protected. Last one, eighth one, long design life with low maintenance cost. Coming to the typical layers of flexible payments, here we can see different layers of flexible pavement. So start from natural subgrade, compacted subgrade, sub-base course, base course, binder course, surface course. Apart from that, we can see the tack coat, prime coat and seal coat. Seal coat we can see at the topmost layers to maintain the smoothness to movement of the vehicles. And tack coat is the layer provided above the binder course. And prime coat is the layer provided above the base course. Here we can see the cross section of flexible pavement and cross section of rigid pavement. In the rigid pavement, here we can see the longitudinal joints. At the center, we can see longitudinal joint. It's run throughout the length of the road. And transverse joint. So every 3 meter or 4 meter intervals, we can see the transverse joint in a concrete pavement. It's not present in a flexible pavement. Coming to the seal coat, so in the picture we can see how to apply the seal coat and where exactly we can apply the seal coat. Seal coat is a thin surface treatment used to waterproof the surface and to provide skid resistance and seal the surfacing against the ingress of water. Then coming to the tack coat. Tack coat is a very light application of asphalt, usually asphalt emulsion diluted with water. It provides proper bonding between the two layers of binder course. It is generally applied on impervious surface. And prime coat. Prime coat is an application of low viscous liquid bituminous materials over an existing porous or absorbent pavement surface like WBM. Prime objective is to plug the capillary voids of the porous surface and to bond the loose materials on the existing surface like granular bases on which binder layers is placed. It provides bonding between two layers. So here we can see where exactly we can apply the prime coat and you know what is the use of prime coat. And here we can see the seal coat and prime coat, where exactly we can provide the seal coat, prime coat and seal coat. Seal coat is provided at the topmost layer to prevent the entry of rainwater, and also it provides the smooth surface to the movement of the vehicles. Also there is the skidding. And typical layers of flexible pavement surface course and flexible pavement and rigid pavements. Coming to the typical layers of flexible pavement, first on binder course. This layer provides to bulk the asphalt concrete structures. Its chief purpose is to distribute the loads to the base course. The binder course generally consists of aggregates having less asphalt and doesn't require quality as such as high as the surface course. So replacing a part of the surface course by the binder course results in more economical design. Coming to the base course. The base course is the layer of material immediately beneath the surface of binder course, and it provides additional load distribution and contributes to the subsurface drainage. It may be composed of crushed stone and other untreated or stabilized materials. Then sub-base course. The surface course is the layer of materials beneath the course, and the primary functions are to be provide structural support, improved drainage. It may be WBM or WMM. A surface course is not always needed or used. For example, a pavement constructed or a high quality. Here we can see the where the sub-base course, here is the sub-base course, in this here is the sub-base course. This is the natural subgrade. Over that we can see the base course. Base course is the combination of base course and binder course. Above that we can see the surface course. Then subgrade. Subgrade, the top soil layer or subgrade is a layer of natural soil prepared to receive the stresses from the layer above. It is essential that At no time to soil subgrade is